this series, my brother and I are playing completely cooperatively, making all the decisions together, and we're also trying to clean up some of the errors we made in some of the other videos that we posted and that many of you were kind enough to point out. So with all of that said, let's jump into the action. All right. So, your setup, we got to do, so we get one diplomacy, six admin, two politics now, right?
Two politics.
And our glory is down to 66. Ever since we defeated Russia, it's just been retreat. Our glory has been retreating
just
quickly.
Been dropping like a rock.
Exactly.
Let's go beat Austria.
All right, let's go beat up on Austria. Nothing added or removed.
Where we are, right?
Oh, actually, sorry, hang on a second. I did want to check. I just want to make sure Forced March isn't in here. Because remember, we had to remove Forced March. Yeah, Forced March is in here. So we're going to take Forced March out of here. Go ahead and reshuffle it since I look through it.
Yep. Remember that one.
Yep. Actually, we can, minus one DRM in all rounds. Okay. That's okay. I still think.
Good one.
Spend the A, put it over there as a campaign modifier. Oops, sorry. I grabbed it from you.
Yep. All good.
You want to have a second bastard, son?
I would love to have one. There he is. That's Napoleon saying, it ain't me, it's you. Did you get the glory?
I got the glory. We've got our second bastard son. Now we need a divorce. All right, so we place that in France.
But we have good harvest.
Yeah, so basically...
they both go away. Right?
Yeah, so I think we have to play it. So this time we're gonna have to roll twice. If this card and Bad Harvest are in play during the may remove both cards from play. So basically, when we get to the domestic politics phase, we just remove them both.
Just get rid of both of those. Yep. Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
We're discarding because we got a wife.
Yeah. Come on.
So close.
Why can't we get divorced?
May as well just discard it with no effect.
Yeah. There's no reason. Let's leave it in the. Let's leave it there. Yeah.
Yeah. Just in case.
Just in case. Yeah. If none of Austria, Prussia, and Russia are hostile. So that's not true, and the second part isn't true. So none of that's true. So we discard with no effect. And that's the end of it. So we go to war with Austria. So minus one for Austrian reform.
Well, we can get a plus one.
Treat stalemates as victory.
The great thing is the stalemate is a victory, and bloody results are ignored.
Yep. And I think, we literally probably could get to plus four without any commanders. So one, two, oh, maybe not. Two.
Yeah, because we lost the Grand Army.
We can't use the Old Guard. Three.
Why?
Oh, sorry, we can use the Old Guard, but we don't want to use the Old Guard because if we use the Old Guard, a stalemate would turn into a defeat first. And then this would not take effect. So we don't want to deploy the Old Guard. So we need 2A we need 2A for Grand Battery and Napoleon's plans. I don't think we need to bring our glory based guys, to be honest with you. We got 1A, freebie, 1P. So 3A and 1P. But I don't think we want to bring all those guys. I think we want to just bring two of the A guys. So we should send one of the A guys back. We'll send Eugene back. Because we want to save, we want to save. So we're going to use two admin for Bonaparte's plans and Grand Battery. We'll get Maneuver sur les derrière just because in the first round. We'll play Secret Intelligence. Might as well to get plus one. So we just need to use one commander here. Yeah, we didn't really need all these commanders. Sorry.
Well, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't
really
matter.
He's going to roll anyway.
Yeah. Probably just shouldn't have brought him. But all right. So plus four. We really can't lose this because the worst we can get is a stalemate. And we're not even going to get that.
All right. Just a straight up victory.
So, play Treaty of Schönbrunn. So we can't play the Treaty of Schönbrunn.
Doesn't exist. So conquer it again.
So we conquer Austria. You got the glory.
When will you learn?
Got the glory and the politics.
One politic, right?
One politic, yep.
Yep.
So then we are rolling for casualties. We got four guys in here. So
nothing.
They're safe.
Nothing.
They're safe. I think, and I moved the campaign modifier card over, so I think we've done campaign cleanup. So diplomatic phase.
And there is no...
So Austria is not rolling. So basically we're just rolling for Prussia, and we might as well actually just roll for them at this point because we kind of would prefer to go to war with them, and we can start working on conquering them. Wouldn't have mattered anyway. All right.
So, it's an even die roll here. Add a few political points and...
Yeah. We got no A to spend. One. So two, we'll spend four to get a plus two.
Yep.
Three G. That's okay.
Saved us again.
Yep. Now, domestic politics phase, we remove both of these cards
those
from play.
Disappear.
And we just roll the ones.
We got to remember that.
Yeah. Oh, shoot. So
we were actually at a five glory.
Yeah, minus two.
And I think we were at five glory the time before, to be honest with you.
Actually, the time before, I seem to remember, I seem to recall remembering Continental System.
A little higher.
So maybe, but maybe not. Because at that point, I think it was because at that point, Prussia was allied, so
that's why that thing is even there to remind us of that. But
I know
it ain't working very well.
Yeah, exactly. Let's put it like in the middle where we're looking at it. Okay. So now that's domestic politics. So cleanup. We didn't use luck. We didn't use diplomacy. So we move on to 1813. So
right. We
lose seven glory, gain two politics, one diplomacy, and six admin. And it's next turn that cards come into play.
That's it, right?
Yep. We are literally playing for divorce at this point.
And there.
Yep. Well, that's actually a good one to have, right? Because we do... Oh, no, we don't have a campaign this turn. That's right. Sorry. So you're going to place him in commanders?
Staff.
I think...
Yeah, chief of staff feels smarter.
No, really? No. I think it's worse.
Chief of staff plus per year... Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
I don't think so. I think you only put him. He's only like there if you're in an emergency, I think. Ah. Oh, wait. We don't have a campaign. I'm forgetting. Confusing this with last turn.
Yep.
Yeah. Commander.
Wow. Up to 11 commanders now.
lot
good
of
thing
campaign.
We don't have a campaign. A
lot of campaign-based stuff at this point. No divorces.
Would have been so easy to have a legitimate heir.
It would have been.
Good night. Is there a reason not to place them in the commanders?
No, I don't think so. I don't think there's ever a reason not to do it. So we put him in Russia. He just has basically...
But it's a useless card.
It is, because Tsar Alexander never ascended to the throne.
Minus one admin.
We removed Bonaparte's plans from play.
Bummer.
It has served us well. But people have gotten wise to our tactics.
Man.
Wow. Very campaign heavy card draw phase. In a card draw phase when we have no interest in a campaign.
Have no campaign.
Yet another one. All right.
So campaign resolution pretty quick.
Everything comes back. So now we are
diplomatic.
Rolling for Prussia, and we would like them to go hostile. Ah, but they don't.
Roll again?
Yes, I actually agree with that. Let's see if we can get a lower roll this time. No.
Just not meant to be hostile.
All right, so now we have a minus one on the domestic politics table, remembering the continental system. Hang on a second before you roll that. So I'm going to spend 4A to get 2 politics, and then I'm going to spend 4 politics to get us plus 2. So this is at a plus 1, right? Didn't matter.
14. Boy, we were above 50 or 100.
Yes, we were.
Yeah.
So, Napoleon's luck, and we reset diplomacy and admin, and we move on to 1814. Now, 1814,
we have a choice,
is where Peace of Europe comes into play.
Which we should clearly play.
Maybe. I mean, the thing is we're
not going to go to war, so go for a divorce.
Yeah, I'm kind of feeling like we should just play out the last few turns, see if we can get a divorce and get a slightly better result than the Peace of Europe. Right. I mean, at this point, the worst thing that could possibly happen is we go to war with Prussia. I mean, it's not that bad.
Ready?
Yep. Oh, lying like a bullet.
Yeah, that was weird.
Oh, there's an extra card there for some reason. Well, let's just call that our second. Now let's call that our second card.
Yeah, our second card. Yeah.
Lose a politics.
Minus one political point.
Come on, if that's not a reason to divorce Josephine, I don't know what is. She didn't help us there. 5 glory, minus 2p.
Yeah, get the glory, minus the 2p.
You're lagging bad again. Oh, dear. Okay.
Well, that's a reason to have just declared.
Well, that's also a place where we could consider using Napoleon's luck, you know. But the other thing is...
We should use Napoleon.
Well, so we should, although we've never gone through this before. So, it's like we're bored. So we're going to go invade Spain.
And what good can come of that?
Plus 10 glory. I mean, like in game turns, none, because we don't need glory anymore. And frankly, we'll probably lose that much in glory from Spanish ulcer expeditions. Like, you know, I mean,
I guess, think we're going for divorce personally.
Yeah, let's unuse Napoleon's luck and go for divorce. Okay, well, thank God they're conquered.
War of 18-something.
Must place in the Americas. Roll a die if Wellington's in play. He's not.
But he is not.
So we can take one politics or one diplomacy every year.
Plus, so we get to choose.
Yep.
Interesting. Come on. Golly.
Feels improbable.
We just can't get divorced.
We can't. Oh. Dang it.
Gosh. All right. Okay. Well, campaign resolution. That was fun.
That was simple. Diplomatic phasals. Roll for Prussia. We used our luck, so we can't roll that again. So we're going to spend 6A for 3 politics, and then we're going to spend 4 politics for plus 2. So we're basically have got a plus 1 to this.
Oops.
There you go.
There you go.
Saved us a couple of glory. And then cleanup. Oh, sorry. And then year 1815. Diplomacy. Admin, politics, and then we should take politics because we really don't care about diplomacy. We're actively wanting Prussia to go hostile.
We're actually trying to undiplomatize.
Yeah, exactly.
You should be able to use your diplomatic point for whatever direction you want.
That's fair enough. I mean, we're just in a weird space where it's like we can't really, like, we don't want to break the. Normally, you can just break a treaty, right? But right now,
but I don't want all 3 of them.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think Austria would go because they're conquered, but I still don't really want to fight Austria and Russia. So. Yeah. Well, there's the Iron Duke.
Oh, but actually, weren't we supposed to do something in the cleanup phase?
No.
Oh, after.
The year after. So we only do that when revealed.
Ooh, boy. Thank God we didn't go to Spain.
Holy cow, yeah. Woo.
That would have hurt.
Yeah. Trafalgar. If Nelson is in play, minus 5G, minus 1P, and remove Nelson from play. Well, that's kind of good, right?
Kind of.
Minus 5G.
I mean, the 5G, I don't think we were going to get there, or maybe just a little more.
But at least we're not going to be losing 2 glory to Nelson anymore. Well, too bad he's in play. Otherwise, we could have invaded Britain, conquered Britain, tried to conquer Britain.
And that goes out of play.
Yep.
Seeing all sorts of...
Ow!
Hey! There you go.
Okay, we place it in I Napoleon. And then what? Now we can immediately trigger it. A mistress, yep. A bastard son, and no legitimate son. You may minus 1A to remove your wife. Sorry, Joseph.
Come on, I'm spending 2 admin just for fun. Just because it took so long.
Sorry, Josephine. Now we just need to draw a new wife. Oh my goodness. Oh, we're so close to what we wanted all along. Oh, God. Thank God we didn't go to Spain. Holy crap.
That would have been bad.
Jeez. don't, let's see, what are our options there?
Yeah,
we should just take 1p, right? Minus 1a to 1p?
Care?
No,
do,
we, yeah.
Do we even want to spend an admin?
Well, I mean, that'll take us from 5
Might
to 4.
Well.
Yeah,
we're
exactly.
Lose it.
It's more efficient than spending it in the domestic politics phase. Come on, wife!
What? Yay!
Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh my God! Have we used luck? No, we. Oh my God! I can't tell you how few times in this game I have managed to get a legitimate son. 9, right?
Bam! You have a son.
Well, we. Come on, it's a cooperative effort.
So we got the 5G, but then we got the sun, so that's 15G.
And 1P.
Right?
Yep. We flip it to its King of Rome side. I don't know why, but we flip it to its King of Rome side. Now, here's the thing. Now we should trigger the Peace of Europe.
Clearly.
If Austria, Prussia, and Russia are all neutral, allied, and active or conquered, they are, right?
They are all allied, neutral, or conquered.
So plus 20G.
Or plus the tree or the Treaty of Leipzig, which is also...
it's also there. So we are at 99 glory and a legitimate son when the game ends. I do not think it's possible to have a better outcome than that, man. I mean, 99 glory...
So where is that, right?
I think you either lost track of which direction you were going. I think it's 13.
Must have.
Game ends with Napoleon on the throne and with a legitimate heir. We are the founder of a dynasty. If Napoleon dies on the throne with a legitimate heir, whether as Emperor of the French or Emperor of Europe, he founds a dynasty that rules France for decades to come. If the dynasty follows natural frontiers, it must still survive the coming of another great bad man, the Prussian Bismarck. But we didn't. And we extended the limits
That'd
of glory.
That'd be a fun one, actually. Bismarck would be fun.
There you go. There you go. You can play this game, and then depending on the outcome of this game, you can play I Bismarck with different starting conditions. I can't tell you how few times I have played this game and ended up with a legitimate heir. It's just...
I can tell you how often I have.
Oh,
never.
Exactly. Precisely once. Wow. That was awesome.
Yep. That was fun. Now I will say my three playthroughs, I've never had to deal with Spain. So which I'm okay with.
Yeah.
But if we hadn't been so close to really good, I would have said, let's go. But
yeah, I mean,
I didn't want to mess that up.
Yeah, I mean, I think the thing is, we were just so blatantly just playing to try to flip the divorce card at that point that it was kind of
amazing that actually worked.
Unnecessary. Well, not only that it came up, but then we also then flipped a wife card. Those two things happen. We still have never been able to. We still have never seen making kings, so we've never been able to get rid of our idiot relatives.
That's true.
But wow, that was. 99 glory and a legitimate
fun.
And a legitimate son. And interestingly, it wasn't a very smooth trip, really, I gotta say. Like, it was a very chaotic middle there. With, like, it's like we were gonna fight this campaign, and then we're fighting that campaign. We went to Russia, then it turned out Prussia and Russia.
Yeah. We also went to Russia once, got the Confederation of the Rhine, and they disappeared before we even got halfway into Russia.
Exactly, exactly, exactly. Way to go, man.
No, that was fun.
That was.
Yep,
that was
nice. I like it.
Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. Hope you're enjoying all of the I, Napoleon content that we're producing, and this series in particular. If you are, it would be great if you could subscribe and hit the like button. Please leave comments if you have questions about anything or if you spot anything we're doing wrong. And also sharing the videos can be very helpful for the channel. But thanks very much, and we'll see you next time on Agility Snips Gaming Table.